home, what joy will fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them, my hand will save. The finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? I will hold your people in my heart.
As it is
give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory
Good morning, and welcome to St. Francis of Assisi for the funeral for Yvonne Miller. I have a few announcements to make before we start, and I apologize for anybody that I pushed around too much. We are really just trying to keep you safe, okay? So, as directed by Archbishop Aitchen, there is a change to the posture during the communion rite. The community will kneel down after the Lamb of God. The distribution of Eucharist will be moved from the end of Mass to its usual position in Mass. If you've been coming to Mass recently, you would know that we have been having communion after the Mass was over. You will be directed by a hospitality minister when it's time to come out of your pew. And at this Mass, we will receive communion up the center aisle, and then you'll return going down the side aisles. For distancing reasons and safety of all, everyone must come out of the pew, whether you are coming forward for a blessing or receiving the body of Christ. So everyone needs to come forward to Father Dick. If you wish to receive a blessing, keep your mask on. And if you wish to receive the body of Christ, remove your mask as the person in front of you is receiving communion. You will need to receive the body of Christ only in your hands, both hands extended toward the minister. Your hands must be kept motionless and flat so that the host can be placed in your hand without touching you. So really flat, okay, like that. Once you have consumed the host, then you must put your mask back on. If you're touched when you're receiving communion, both you and the priest will need to sanitize your hands. There's hand sanitizer on those two tables in the front and also over there, okay? Everyone except immediate family must stay 6 feet apart as you're coming forward and moving around in the church. Once you return to your pew, you will kneel down or sit until Father Dick is seated in his chair after the communion. And then at the end of Mass, to ensure that people safely exit the building, a hospitality minister will direct you. The family will leave first, and then we will dismiss from the back of the church to the front pews. Hope that all made sense.
I invite you all to rise. We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we gather here today for the funeral for Yvonne, we sprinkle her cremated remains with holy water, reminding us of her baptism in the Lord God, Father, and Spirit. So in the waters of baptism, Yvonne died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving to each other we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
I'd like to welcome Yvonne's family that she leaves behind, her children, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren, and Wayne's grandchildren and great-grandchildren. There's a whole list of those people in your program that you can catch up with. There's a whole ton of them there. Anyway, we welcome them and welcome all of you as we gather here to celebrate the funeral for Yvonne. We know that because of the code, we're limited in how many people can attend this, and so we're kind of restricted in what we can do and how we do some certain things. So let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Yvonne, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. If you be seated now for our readings from the Holy Scriptures. So I'd ask Alicia and Jared and Jim to come forward.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. For this reason, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches, he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God.
Psalm 63. Please join me in the response. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. O God, you are my God, whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth, parched, lifeless, and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary, to see your power and your glory, for your kindness is greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus will I bless you while alive. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings, I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you. Your right hand upholds me. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
My mother asked for Antonio Costa, her grand nephew and godson, to do a reading, but because of COVID, he's not able to be here today. And so, in honor of him, and certainly an honor to me, I was asked to do the reading. A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. So we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please Him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. This is the word of the Lord.
He'll rise. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When he saw the crowds, Jesus went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. If you'll all be seated. We gather here today, as I said, to honor Yvonne, to remember her, to pray for the family that she leaves behind. The scripture reading is chosen by the family, and they asked me to choose the gospel reading from Matthew, a reflection of what Jesus teaches us about life and about death, that we are here on this earth for a while, and someday every one of us will pass from this life and be faced with the judgment of our God. And how we have lived our lives depends on what we have done in this world of ours, how we have loved and how we have shared that love, how we have helped others in need, how we have given ourselves to one another in the ways that we are able to do that. The gospel I just read to you, the Beatitudes, is the first sermon of Jesus on the Mount, and it's a kind of a guide other than the commandments of God of how it is that we are asked to live our lives. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, those who are meek, those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, the merciful, the clean of heart, peacemakers, and even those who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness. That, for me, is a kind of reflection of who Yvonne was in this world of ours. A person who loved the Lord her God, a person who lived her life in that righteous, loving kind of way to bring that hope and salvation and peace not only to herself, but to those around her as well. As a member of this parish, she was always here on Sundays to worship her God. She was here with her husband, first husband. I first came here, and he died shortly after I got here. Then she married Wayne, and Wayne has come here whenever he was in town, along with her. But Yvonne was that kind of a person who emanated that kind of love of God in her heart, a love that she shared with her family, a love that she shared with all those that she met in this world of ours. Her kindness, her generosity, her beauty, her willingness to serve in so many different kinds of ways, I'm sure that you have experienced from her. Her ability to listen, her ability to share life with you, her ability to bring good things into the world of ours by her goodness to you, her goodness to strangers, her goodness to so many other people in this world of ours. She knew who God was in her life. She loved her God, and she shared that love of God with all her family and everybody else in so many different ways. I got to know Yvonne a little bit through this parish and her being here at church and through the ways in which she was involved in our parish here. She was always this very gentle, loving, graceful person, this person who was able to bring the love of God to those that she met, to those that she whose hearts she touched by giving of herself in so many different kinds of ways. A gentle spirit who brought that gentleness in all of her relationships. I read in her program all the notes from her grandchildren, and all of them reflect that sense of love that they experience from Yvonne, that sense of grace that they experience, whether they're eating ice cream or desserts or on a boat or in a cabin someplace and just enjoying life because she was able to make that happen for them in so many different kinds of ways. And I'm sure all of you who knew her knew this love and grace in her life, knew the gentleness of her heart, knew the goodness that she brought to you just by her presence and by the ways in which she listened, the ways in which she blessed you, the ways in which she was just there for you at any moment of your life. We pray for the family that she leaves behind, her children, her grandchildren, great-grandchildren on both sides of the family, because they have a hole in their heart, because Yvonne, I'm sure, played a big part in their lives. And now that she is physically gone from their lives, even though they've known the suffering that she has gone through in the last days of her life, just slowly going from this world of ours, that they know now that she is spiritually present to them, not so much physically present as she was before. But we know that they are in the embrace of God in their lives. We know that Yvonne is watching, looking down upon them today from the embrace of God in heaven. And we know that all will be well for you eventually as you continue to grieve and as you continue to experience the loneliness of your heart without your mother, your grandmother, your great-grandmother, your dear friend, that person who in your life was so important to you and blessed you in so many different kinds of ways. I think what we have to take away from her life is that somehow as she blessed you, that we need to learn how to bless each other. That we need to learn how to be as graceful as she was graceful, as so present to you in so many ways, so loving and so kind in so many different ways in which she touched your life. And the legacy that we can help of hers that we can bring to this world is to do a little bit of what she was able to do for you. To live a little bit as she lived her life, to bring that goodness and that love that she brought to you in so many different kinds of ways. And if you can do that in remembrance of Yvonne, then you can bring her presence, continued presence, in this world of ours to people who may or may not have known her, but because you have touched their lives as she has touched your life, that they may continue to go forward in the world maybe being a little bit better, a little bit more grateful for God's goodness, and a little bit more cheerful and joyful and engaged in life because you have brought the spirit of Yvonne to each one of them by the ways in which you share her love and her goodness, her blessing that you received, that you might share that in so many different ways with others.
If you'll rise now and ask Kimberly to come forward now for the prayers of intercession. You want to come up here? This way is easier. My friends, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
For Yvonne's family and friends who shared a long and fruitful life with her. We pray that we will continue to celebrate her life through the strength of God's grace and be living examples of her faithfulness to you and those she loved. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we be reminded of Yvonne's love with every full moon, gentle breeze, ice cream cone, and warm morning sun. May your grace shine upon us as we continue her legacy through each new generation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for Yvonne's life and all the years she shared as a wife, mother, sister, aunt, grandmother, great-grandmother, and friend, we thank you for every moment of love and joy. We lift her to you today in your promise of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Yvonne may rest and rejoice in your everlasting love and glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a moment, let us call to mind our own memories of Yvonne. For these and all the intentions we hold in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives are purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. If you'll be seated now, so continue. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. You'll rise. Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O God, for the salvation of your servant Yvonne, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful God, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. May this time either kneel or be seated as we continue with our Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O God, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O God, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O God, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O God, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, Eusebio, and Daniel, our bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful God, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Yvonne, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. If you'll all rise. At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O God, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Either kneel or be seated now as we continue with communion. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament's body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Yvonne may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. If you'll be seated now, as John and Pam and Lowell come forward to say something about Yvonne.
A big thanks to everyone for joining us, both present and away, and thank you for loving our mom. Today is a wonderful day to celebrate mom, your sister, your aunt, your grandma, your great-grandma, your godmother, and your friend. She suffers no more, and we rejoice in knowing that God's promise has been fulfilled. Our entire family is so grateful to Wayne. Wayne, your steadfast love and support for Mom, especially over the past several years, was truly a beautiful love. For better or for worse, for rich or for poor, in sickness and in health, it was a gift to see you and your endless love and support. These examples were love in action. In reflection of Mom's faith, love, courage, and strength, what a blessing it was to witness the way she shared each of these actions freely, while combining them with countless deeds. Mom was authentic and intentional with each stroke of her pen. And with her chosen words, she gave only love. Mom made every bouquet last forever. She would clip, sort, cull, rearrange, and refresh until only a single flower remained. And this is how she cared for each of us. Mom's 19 grandchildren were extremely important to her. She loved each one of you as a special and unique individual. May her loving examples give each of you a lasting light. With grace, Mom taught us how to love. And with faith, she taught us how to live. We cherish her thoughtfulness, patience, and kindness, and enjoyed how she connected with people from all walks of life. She gave advice not so much through her words, but through her works, and with zero strings attached. She was courageous. I was amazed as I watched her steer the powerless Miller's High Life up and down steep waves in an unexpected raging storm in the Straits of Georgia, and then helped me catch a saving lifeline flung to our bow so we could be towed safely to port. And one day at a time, Mom fought lupus and beat it. Years later, her beautiful handwriting diminished in size, and she learned of her Parkinson's disease. And while she knew Parkinson's could one day take her, she was determined not to let it define her. She adjusted and learned to live well. And with Wayne's support, they added many wonderful years together, well beyond what she could have done alone. No matter how weak Mom became, with each and every visit of our support, we always left with the feeling that she gave us more than we provided. I worked on many things with Mom. Over the past few years, but in new ways, I learned why she was so successful in her works. Her organizational skills were extraordinary. Mom succeeded in making things not only easy for herself, but for everyone else around her, while never appearing to break a sweat. Her diligence was in caring for all aspects of her life. Each of us has various trials of how the coronavirus has affected us. It was so painful. To hold back from a warm embrace or a sweet kiss for Mom. But we are grateful for the amplified gift of time each of us were able to spend with Mom during her most difficult days. So while we're going to miss our lunch and ice cream dates, amazing, delicious family dinners with special centerpieces, your cauliflower salad and lazy daisy cake, and yes, those peanut butter cookies, we'll carry your traditions forward with the extra love you left in each of us. You left no box unchecked, Mom. I love you.
What a special room of people this is. You're here for a reason. You touched Mom. She touched you, I know. I had a 4-hour layover on my way to Seattle. And I thought, Mom's list. She has a whole list of people she wants me to call. So that's what I did. And I found myself this whole 3 weeks, I think it's been, fog carrying through on Mom's wishes. Notes for me to do this, notes for me to give this to the grandchildren. Talk about organized, and she's still doing it. It's amazing. 3 years ago, I vowed to Mom that I would come home and make quarterly visits. And I've been doing that for 3 or 4 years, and I look back now, and I just think, wow, what a gift. I had those special one-on-one times. When I first came home, it was to help her declutter, get things more in order, even though they were in order. And we got a lot done. But as time went on, she wasn't able to do that so well anymore. So we would just spend time together. It was quiet time for me. Sometimes it was a little boring, but it was time with Mom. A year ago, June, a few of us kids were sitting around talking with Mom, and I wanted to know how she wanted to be remembered. We've never really had that conversation, what song she might want to have sung on her day of celebration. That's when we learned that her classmates remembered her as a woman that would never have a hair out of place. And when I tell people that, they say, and she never did. That's also when we learned that she named herself Agent X in the FBI. We had no idea that she was Agent X. She was funny. Nobody really knew that, but she just, I wish I had all the momisms that I've experienced with her. She was always available and always willing to talk openly. She told us she wanted to share. Her whole goal was to be open to her body. And my, if anybody ever was, it was our mom. When she fought that lupus and those doctors found out she had no sign of it, they were more than astonished. And when told Parkinson's, as John said, she knew it would not define her. She fought so hard, and she wanted to let go so bad. I was really at peace with Mom. Every time I came home, I wasn't sure if it was the last time I'd see her. But we were okay. We had lots of talks. We were very much at peace. And she told me, Pam, if something happens and you're not here, please, it's okay. I'm so thankful I was here. I flew on the 8th of July, hoping I would make it. 11 days later, we are watching her wondering, how is she hanging on? July 4th, she decided, no more meds. I'm done. I am just done. I'm not going to get better. She didn't want to eat. And we honored that. It was hard, but we honored it. And we just kept saying, Mom, what's holding you? What's keeping you here? And she would say, when she could, clutter, stuff, too many things. I think it was my brother Jim said, you are one strong woman, Mom. And she said, too strong. She just wouldn't let go. And then a couple of weeks ago, my sister-in-law Jamie found a poem that has been very fitting for us. Every day is a new beginning. Take a deep breath, smile, and begin again. God woke you up today for a reason. Trust in his plan. His timing is perfect. He will make a way. Amen. So talk about timing. Mom passes at 5:13 on Sunday, July 19th. 5:13. She has five kids. 13, her lucky number. She was born on Friday the 13th. July, the seventh month, seven family members. The 19th, who's most important in her world? Her 19 grandchildren. Pretty incredible when we added all of those numbers up and what they meant. We figured out that was the perfect time. Later on that day, we're sitting around the table. Mom's favorite place on the deck overlooking the Puget Sound, Cascade, Olympic Mountains. And my brother Jim goes, sort of, he said this. Oh my gosh, you've got to be kidding me. He went, got this poem, read it to us, and he said, my daughter Haley just told me what day it is. It's National Ice Cream Day. Go figure. Her big thing was ice cream with her grandkids. And that's really when our light went on and went, you've got to be kidding me, National Ice Cream Day, only grandma. So anyway, the next day, July 20th, was a new moon, and our next full moon is August 3rd, and Mom, we'll see you under the moon. Love, peace, hope, and joy.
How much does a polar bear weigh? Enough to break the ice, all right. I, like many of us, could speak volumes about Grandma, but like her stature, I shall keep it short and sweet. What Grandma Yvonne's passing has reaffirmed in my own personal consciousness is that through her death, each of us are presented with an opportunity, a duty, if you will. And that duty is to continually fan the flame that she has lit deep within each of our hearts. As I look out at the familial congregation before me, I see a collection of torchbearers blessed with the responsibility of sustaining Yvonne's vivid light. For years to come, as we gather together and reunite in varying capacities, that light shall burn a little brighter yet. But perhaps it's those inevitable moments, those dark days where time simply marches on, where that little flame blossoms into a guiding light. For one mustn't forget that all you have to do to be renewed in Yvonne's light is to gaze upon the moon. I'm going to share a little excerpt from a novel written in 1949 by Paul Bowles called The Sheltering Sky. Death is always on the way, but the fact that you don't know when it will arrive seems to take away from the finiteness of life. It's that terrible precision that we hate so much. But because we don't know, we get to think of life as an inexhaustible well. Yet everything happens a certain number of times, and a very small number, really. How many more times will you remember a certain afternoon of your childhood? Some afternoon that's so deeply a part of your being that you can't even conceive of your life without it. Perhaps 4 or 5 times more, perhaps not even. How many more times will you watch the full moon rise? Perhaps 20, and yet it all seems limitless. Enjoy life. This is not a dress rehearsal. Love y'all.
Thank you all for coming and celebrating our mom's life. Dear Mom, because of you, the world is a better place. Your journey through space and now in heaven, no doubt you passed Comet Neowise at warp speed. Your love and memories remain here on Earth with us. We know FBI Agent X will continue to watch over us and shine a bright light on our paths. I love you, Mom.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again. The love of Christ who conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Traditionally, we'd have incensing of the cremated remains, but because incense causes some people to cough. We're not allowed to use incense these days, so. If you respond to the following verses, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, God of mercies, we commend our sister Yvonne to the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us, listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother and sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. The thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
The family will process out first with the cremated remains of Yvonne, and then you'll be directed to leave the church starting from the back down the center aisle. So if the person who's going to carry out the ashes come forward and...
solo sogno l'orizzonte. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me, con me su. Le finestre mostrano tutto il mio cuore che è acceso. Chiudi dentro me la luce che ha incontrato.
Sogno all'orizzonte manca le parole. Io sì lo so che sei con me, tu mia luna, tu sei qui con me. Mio sole, tu sei qui con me.
Oh,